Discovered more than a century ago, X-rays are still topical, with the use of digital imaging in medicine. Conventional radiography is still the best way of looking at bones, and viewing certain organs, such as the digestive system or the arterial system, by injecting a contrast medium. But it only gives a flat view, on which the shadows of the organs can merge into one another. The X-ray scanner, invented in the 1970s, overcomes this drawback. It is an X-ray emitter which rotates in a ring. The patient lies on a table, which moves inside the ring. The scanner scans the body in successive slices, and the sensors send back data, which is converted into high-precision images.
Tout ce qu'on a vu jusqu'à présent, c'était une projection. Ici, on a un examen du thorax. C'était la projection du thorax sur un plan. Et là, maintenant, on va faire des coupes qui vont nous permettre de voir les détails à l'intérieur de ce thorax. Et on arrive à voir tous les détails, c'est-à-dire séparément les vertèbres, les vaisseaux, les voies aériennes et la paroi du thorax et les poumons de chaque côté.
Despite the precision of the images, we can't see everything with X-rays or check that an organ is working correctly. For this, doctors use another technique using radioactivity, which was developed in the mid-20th century, nuclear medicine.
Pour explorer le fonctionnement de la glande thyroïde, on emploie l'iode radioactif, dont la préparation est entièrement automatique. La solution d'iode, à teneur inoffensive, est ingérée par le malade. Un écran limite exactement la zone à explorer, au-dessus de laquelle est amené le détecteur. Le médecin va savoir comment la glande malade a capté l'iode et pourra formuler un diagnostic précis.
The levels of radioactivity are initially recorded manually on a drawing. So functional images are obtained rather than anatomical images, as they show how the thyroid had taken up the iodine. The arrival of the gamma camera in the 1960s revolutionized nuclear medicine by taking into account imaging. To obtain an image, the radioactive medium is introduced into the body. The medium attaches itself selectively to the organ to be examined. The gamma camera detects the radiation that is emitted, and the computer system reconstructs the accurate image of the distribution of the tracer in real time. Since the early 20th century, doctors have had an even more sensitive instrument, the PET camera. It is mainly used for the study of cancers, as it can be used to detect small tumors that were until then invisible.
Pour voir une tumeur, un cancer, il faut l'éclairer. En radiologie, on l'éclaire avec des rayons X. En médecine nucléaire et avec la TEP, on va apporter la lumière dans la tumeur. Alors, une fois que la molécule qui contient donc la lumière a été injectée au patient, elle est captée par différents organes au niveau du corps humain, des organes qui consomment normalement du sucre, comme ici le cerveau, puisque l'homme est un animal pensant, le cœur qui ne cesse pas de battre. Et si on se déplace à la recherche de la tumeur qui consomme également du sucre, on la voit apparaître ici au niveau du thorax.
These examinations give doctors indispensable information for them to provide the appropriate treatment. But we must not forget the harmful effects of radiation. The following three rules of radiation protection must be followed for staff. Limit the time staff are near radioactive sources. Move away from sources. Work in glove boxes and use lead-lined syringe carriers. For patients, there must be additional examinations when the doctor needs to confirm a diagnosis. And in all cases, the patient must receive the lowest possible exposure without harming the quality of the images.
Oui, la radiothérapie, c'est l'utilisation médicale à des fins thérapeutiques, donc pour traiter les malades qui ont un cancer. Et cette radiothérapie utilise déjà depuis plus d'un siècle les rayonnements.
Radiation has become stronger and stronger with the development of radioactive materials and sources. Today, X-rays produced by particle accelerators like this one are widely used. To reach a deep tumor, the beam of rays cannot avoid passing through healthy tissue. To protect this healthy tissue, tumors are more often than not irradiated with convergent beams by rotating the source around the patient. The volume to be treated is therefore irradiated a great deal more than the surrounding tissue. The irradiation is also divided into a number of sessions, using the fact that cancerous cells are more sensitive to radiation than normal cells. The lesions in the healthy tissue have time to repair themselves between each session, whereas they accumulate in the disease tissue.
Il n'y a pas de traitement sans un minimum d'effets secondaires. Quant à ces effets secondaires, on les a bien connus, bien analysés. Et de là, nous sommes remontés vers la radioprotection, à savoir comment traiter de mieux en mieux les malades.
Nevertheless, it can be seen that patient exposure is the result of a compromise between the minimum exposure required to destroy the tumor and the exposure limit above which healthy tissue will be damaged.
Ce qui est intéressant, c'est que la radioprotection est devenue pour nous un support, un point de départ pour nous permettre de rebondir et d'améliorer les traitements que nous donnons à nos malades actuellement.
Radiation protection plays a vital role in radiotherapy. But recent accidents in France and other countries remind us that this area of specialization, which has made huge advances in the last decade, but has also become much more complex, must be carried out by highly qualified staff who apply the most advanced quality control techniques and comply scrupulously with radiation protection rules. Whether it is in the field of radiography, nuclear medicine, or radiotherapy, radiation protection has developed over time. Originally a requirement, radiation protection has become a tool for improving quality of care, which benefits staff and also, above all, patients.